Hello, dear friends. Welcome back, friends. We have discussed about the aqueous humor and how is the aqueous humor produced. Right now, this was the composition of the aqueous humor. Now we are going to discuss about the drainage of the aqueous humor. How the aqueous humor is drained. Welcome back, friends. Let's discuss about the drainage of the aqueous humor. My dear friends, we will make an enlarged diagram. First of all, I will make a small diagram, then we will enlarge that part and we will discuss the drainage of the aqueous humor. So if this is your eye, right, my dear friends, okay, then there is your cornea, okay, and behind it there is your ciliary body, right, also ciliary body here. This is your iris, right, and there you have your lens suspended by the zonules of Zinn or suspensory ligaments, right, and here is the aqueous humor produced by the ciliary epithelium of the ciliary process. I have written here, and this is your aqueous humor, and aqueous humor is going towards the interior chamber and it has been accommodated in the interior chamber. Now you know that when there is the constant production or constant supply of the aqueous humor, then there must be the drainage, otherwise there will be an increase in the intraocular pressure of the eye, and that we will be that will be glaucoma, series of other complications which will cause your eye to have larger pressure in the interior or posterior chamber. So that is called glaucoma. So look carefully, if there is the supply or production, there is also the drainage. So actually the aqueous humor is produced in the posterior chamber and drained from the anterior chamber. This is the very important objective type. It is produced in the posterior chamber and drained into the anterior chamber from the anterior chamber. So this is the important point that we should clear now in a bigger diagram, and we should know that from this point how the aqueous humor is drained, right? So this is called the angle of the anterior chamber. This important point is called the angle of anterior chamber, or we call it iridocorneal angle. Iridocorneal angle we call it, and we will see why it is called iridocorneal angle. And this iridocorneal angle contains actually the drainage system for your aqueous humor, which is called the canal of Schlemm. This is called canal of Schlemm. Right, now let me enlarge this important point. I will enlarge it there and we will discuss how this fluid is drained. Let's do it, friends. First of all, there should be there is the part of the ciliary body, pars plicata, pars plana, and this is ciliary body. Then you know that there is your iris. This is iris, right? And you know that above it there is your sclera is there, right? This is your sclera, right? Now to the sclera, you know there is the connection of your cornea. This is your cornea, right? So we know that it is present also here. So we just want to know about only this angle. Now look carefully. Look, here is an angle formed, right? And this is called the angle of the anterior chamber. Now this angle of the anterior chamber is formed by some parts of this iris, the anterior parts of this iris, some parts of this ciliary body, the sclera, and some parts of your cornea. So here is an angle formed, and this angle is called the angle of anterior chamber, or we call it irido corneal angle. Corneal angle, right? And this irido corneal angle is formed by some parts of this iris. This is your iris. This is your ciliary body. This is sclera, and this is some parts of the cornea. Now look at this important point on all sides of the eye. As you know, the eye is a rounded structure, right? And there will be the other parts of the eye, right? So this is an rounded structure, and we have made a section, right? So there is a drainage system, and this drainage system is called the canal of Schlemm. Now look carefully, friends. Here is the tube present. It is dipped, actually it is dipped into the sclera of your eye. So look, this is a tube like structure, and this is dipped into your sclera. Now this tube or this canal is actually connected to a very fine networks of small capillaries, a very fine network of very small diameter capillaries. And these small capillaries are present all over the eye, right? These are the small capillaries through which the drainage of this aqueous humor occur. And you know, my dear friends, if this is your eye, right, round structure, this is the lateral view and this is the anterior view. So my dear friends, I'm making this because to clear the confusion, right? And we have taken out the cornea, and we are looking here, right? We are looking here. Look carefully. This is your cornea, and at very this place, these networks of capillaries are present there. These networks of these capillaries are present there, and these capillaries are again in contact with the canal of Schlemm. So this is your canal of Schlemm around those capillaries, and you know that we have taken this section, we have made a section here. Now we can see these capillaries, right? These capillaries we can see here, and we can see this canal of Schlemm about it, and this canal of Schlemm is all around, and these capillaries are also all around. So these capillaries are called the trabecular meshwork, right? These are called trabecular meshwork, right? And now look carefully. When the ciliary epithelium of the ciliary processes produce the aqueous fluid or aqueous humor, they come to the posterior chamber, and through the pupil they come towards the anterior chamber, and in the anterior chamber they circulate and supplies nourishment to the cornea, the posterior surface of the cornea. Then they drain to these through these trabecular meshwork, and then from these trabecular meshwork they drain into this canal of Schlemm. Now look carefully, this is our canal of Schlemm, right? Okay, so the aqueous fluid is drained into the meshwork, right, trabecular meshwork, and from the trabecular meshwork these fluids enter into the canal of Schlemm, and the canal of Schlemm is connected to the collector venules or capillaries. We say to the collector capillaries, they are connected there. Yeah, okay, so let's make another diagram here. Some small diameter capillaries again. So these capillaries are called the collector capillaries, or we call them collector channels, right, friends? So look, very simply, from the anterior chamber through the iridocorneal angle, or the angle of anterior chamber, right? The fluid enters into the trabecular meshwork, and from trabecular meshwork it enters to the canal of Schlemm, and from canal of Schlemm it is collected by the collector capillaries, and from collector capillaries actually they enter into the aqueous veins, right? So there are some small veins which contain only these aqueous fluids. So I will mention them with different colors so as to have a clear concept. Then they enter to the aqueous capillaries or aqueous channels, right? And from these aqueous channels, right, from these aqueous channels, these fluids will be collected by the episcleral veins, right? Then episcleral veins, right? And these episcleral veins will join the large extraocular veins, right? They will join the large extraocular veins, right? And these large extraocular veins will eventually drain into the ophthalmic veins, right? So this is your ophthalmic vein, and ophthalmic veins will take that drain substance and will carry them towards the venous system of your body. So my dear friends, I hope you understood the drainage of the aqueous fluid and the production of the aqueous fluid which was presented in the previous diagram. I know you have watched that also. So friends, this was about the drainage of the aqueous fluid drainage. Now we talked about the basics of the aqueous fluid, how it is produced and how it is drained. So this was the end of the lecture regarding the aqueous humor, friends. I hope you have watched these lectures. I hope you have enjoyed these lectures. So please see you in the next lectures, guys. We will discuss about the blood supply of the eye, and then we will finish with the eye. So see you in the next lectures. Till then, Allah Hafiz.